Right, Mr. Lord Mayor, just move Councillor Christine Banks. Councillors, ladies and gentlemen, in the unlikely event of the fire alarm being activated, please leave the town hall using one of the nearest designated fire exits. Form up on the assembly point at the rear and exchange flags. Kindly ensure all mobile phones are switched off.
Thank you. Just a matter as members stand, apologies for absence of DC and councillors. Alison Clark, Nick Cross, Anthony Rebell, James Roberts, Carol Sutton, Kenny Wood, Claire Woodhouse, Lucy Horn and Pauline Walton. Are there any other fake apologies to be called?
Lord Mayor, from that, I have an urgent question that just needs to be addressed at the beginning of the meeting. I have here a letter that is banning Josie Mullen from attending council meetings. It appears to be an arbitrary decision, and I'd just like to know what standing orders are being adhered to in this decision. Could you please point that out to me? And if not, could we find out what the right of appeal is on this matter, please?
Councillor Crowe, she's been disrupting council meetings in this chamber, and she hasn't done it on one occasion. She's done it on more than one occasion, where she marched down with a group of people here on her bicycle. And she was told time and time again she had to go through the right process, and she ignored that. That's why she's banned from this chamber. Well, she's been told if she kicks up on this chamber again, I'll front march it out myself. That's why. And that's the only answer I'm going to give you. I'm sorry.
Could the party have been a fair process followed in this case?
No one disrupts this chamber, and I'm telling you, she's done it more than once. She can't be doing it again. I think she's going to get away with it. She's not. Start. I'm not going to enter anything like that, calling people across the chamber. Questions being asked, I've answered it, that's it, no more. Okay. Freedom of the city. Mayor Anderson?
Lord Mayor, can I move in pursuance of Section 249 of the Local Government Act 1972 that the honorary freedom of the city be kept conferred on Phil Redmond? Phil Redmond is synonymous with the city's culture, from Grange Hill, Brookside, Hollyoaks, he has put our city on the map and transformed television. He's responsible for giving the people the first break in the Liverpool Star's Coldcourt screen and off. Who are still working in those programmes today, Anna Friel, Frank Foxwell Boyce, Jimmy McGovern, Ricky Tomlinson, Sue Johnston, Gillian Carey, and many more. His charity work and voluntary work are just as impressive. He has chaired the National News Liverpool for nearly 10 years. He was creative chair of European Capital of Culture, stepping in 2007 to support and shape the final programme. He fronted that year with a passion and a tenacity which drove its success. He gives tirelessly to charities and both in time and money. He went on to take learning from Liverpool and create the city of culture, not only in other parts of the UK, Hull for instance, and Derry, Londonderry, but he's also supporting other European capital of culture bits across Europe. His art has always been in the city, He now chairs the City Region Cultural Partnership, and he's a true benevolence councillor who's given back in spades over many, many years to the city he loves and truly deserves this accolade.
Thank you for that. Second,
Councillor.
Good
Mayor,
second
that
motion.
Is that agreed?
Well, I'd like to support that motion. I'm not a great follower of soaps, and it took me about 2 years to understand why people outside Liverpool kept asking me if I had a patio. And I did explain that I only had a yard, but then I discovered the significance of the patio in a famous murder. I first came in touch with Phil Redmond, many councillors did, when he gave the sterling work in support of our capital of culture. He was the mainstay of that program. He did it on a voluntary basis because that showed his commitment to our city. And as the mayor has said, he then went on to really give 10 years to our national museums and galleries on Merseyside. These are a huge tourist attraction for us. Not only are they a great benefit to the people of Liverpool, who go in there any time, see children scurrying around looking at things and doing things, they become a mainstay of our tourist offer. This is a man who is truly worthy of this award, and I hope that by giving it him, I'm sure he'll be doing this anyway, we can get him even more involved in carrying on the cultural work of the city. Thank you, Madam.
Councillor Brown.
Well, Mayor, the Greens also support the awarding of Freedom of the City to Phil Redmond. Pretty much of the 80s, Grange Hill was absolutely my favourite show. Absolutely brilliant, but obviously that's what gave him the profile. The reason he's getting Freedom of the City is because of all the work he's done for the city since then, working with John Moores, helping students with, do media studies, and also his work for Liverpool Museums, work he did on capital culture. Done a huge amount to move Liverpool forward in terms of culture, and he's been a great ambassador for the city.
Thank you. That's okay. Thank you. So,
But it also works both ways. I have to say, we popped out of the little community coach trip to Clavendo, and the Methodist chapel in Clavendo was actually formed by Liverpudlians returning to Wales. So the connection works both ways. So I think it's very, very tasteful, very appropriate that we celebrate this contribution, not just the Welsh community, but we celebrate the whole contribution of the Welsh community to the city in religious and civic life throughout. Thank you, my Lord Mayor.
My Lord Mayor, it's a particular pleasure for me and my colleagues Liz and Andrew Wilkinson to support this motion today. Ben is a constituent of ours, and his chapel is in our ward. It isn't the chapel it was, because many of you will know the chapel at the end of Penny Lane used to be able to seat 500 people, and when Ben first came to Liverpool more than 50 years ago, he could fill it. And at that time there were more than 30 Welsh chapels of various congregationalist and other orders in this city. Now we're down to 3, and only one of them, if I recall correctly, actually conducts its services in Welsh. That used to create a problem for us, because many of you would have been to the annual Welsh civic service, and all most of us could do was stand up and sit down for a great time, because everything was conducted in Welsh, but I must tell you, it did sound beautiful. But it's also an opportunity for us, as Councillor Rufford has alluded to just say something about the Welsh influence in this city. If you live in a terraced house in this city, it was almost certainly built by Welsh builders. 110,000 of them they built, or half a Birkenhead and lots of other places as well. Liverpool had such a big Welsh community that they had their own Liverpool Welsh language newspaper, which came out on a weekly basis, and those are now recorded in our archives. So, again, as Councillor Radford has said, we remember more easily the Irish influence than the Welsh. But never let's forget, there's an item on the agenda which is going to go through with your party about the importance of immigrants to this country, but the importance of immigrants to this city, particularly from Ireland and Wales, 100 to 150 years ago, Liverpool wouldn't be the proud city it is without those Celtic influxes. We welcome them and we still see their influence in the city today.
Thank you for that. Councillor Brown.
Thank you, Lord Mayor, and the Greens will also be supporting the awarding of citizen honour to Dr. D. Ben Rees. Living quite close to the Welsh streets, I'm obviously very aware of the Welsh influence in Liverpool, and further south into St Michael's are quite a lot of streets named after Welsh people as well, so they clearly have a massive impact on the city, and Dr. D. Ben Rees have been a really great advocate for Welsh culture here in Liverpool. I wasn't overly familiar with his work until I saw this come to the agenda, but looking at the range of subjects he's written and published on, such as Welsh culture, obviously, but also peace and pacifism and obscure cultural movements in Wales, I think we can all learn something from him, and I think we could all become better councillors if we knew more about him. Thank you.
Thank you,
Councillor
Brown. Councillor Simon. Is that agreed?
Agreed.
Thank you. Now we move to the ordinary meeting.
Okay. Well, may I just remind you